What's up, everyone? Pritch here, and today we're going to go over all the changes going to the Sword and Shield that are currently on the public test server already that are going to be making their way live in the November patches. Alright, main goal of the changes to the Sword and Shield was to make the Leaping Strike ability feel a bit better, as well as improve the buffering for heavy attacks to make them more consistent to use. Fixed an issue where basic attack buffers and cancels weren't working properly during the Sword Heavy attack. I will be the first to admit that I have not used a bunch of sword heavy attacks in my life, so I'm not 100% on the buffers not working correctly, but hopefully now they're working better. Fixed an issue where the fully charged sword heavy attack had different timings than the regular heavy attack. I didn't pick up on that either. The fully charged heavy attack, for those wondering, is I press and hold left mouse button until my character has done the attack. A regular heavy attack is when you hold down the button to begin the heavy attack animation, then you let go of the button before the maximum time, and you would do it anyways, and you would do a quicker one, and that's, you would do less damage, but it's faster. Shield rush. Improved rush. Increased weaken duration from 4 seconds to 10 seconds. That is huge. Not only is that huge, that is insane for 1v1s, where I believe Sword and Shield already shines. For those that don't believe me, check out the 1v1 tournament I did and watch Snorlax. Freaking insane. That is a 150% buff, by the way, to the duration. Oh my gosh. Leaping Strike. This ability sucks. Nobody's using it right now. Reduced cooldown from 25 seconds to 18 seconds. By the way, Leaping Strike is the one where you leap like 5 or 6 meters and you poke something with your sword. Increased damage scaling from 135% to 150%. That's solid damage. Sped up the recovery after using Leaping Strike to make it easier to transition into other attacks. That, I can tell you right now, is going to be the biggest buff to this ability. If you did that, if you sped up the recovery on like 90% of abilities in this game would feel so much better combat-wise and would feel so much more fluid. I'm just going to throw that out there. I hope whatever you just did to Leaping Strike, you do to every strength weapon. I would argue every weapon in the game. Just going to throw that out there. Cowardly Punishment. Updated description to include the slow percentage value. I am going to just smile and say, I hope that they are going to continue to update tooltips where they are missing information. It would make someone's life very easy in making weapon guides. I'm just going to throw that out there. Alright, that is all for the Sword and Shield, ladies and gentlemen. As always, I love you guys. I appreciate you guys. I'll catch you in the next one. See ya. Boom!